We wanted to take some time to talk about the group of medications that are called narcotic or opioid medications. These medications are chemically related to opium and heroin. For more than 150 years, this family of medications have been used to help us help patients control pain. While they may have been helpful for many people, there are some people who have had a very difficult time after they start taking these medications. Within as little as 1 week of time after they're used, some people will build up a tolerance to them. Tolerance is different from addiction, which we think of as more of a craving for the medication. Tolerance means that you will actually feel more pain when you stop taking the medication for a while until your body is able to adapt to the medication being gone. If you are taking a narcotic or opioid medication for 3 weeks or more, it can become very difficult to stop taking them without continuing to have pain because of the medication. We have learned that patients who have been taking narcotic or opioid medications like hydrocodone or oxycodone before surgery are more likely to experience a greater amount of pain after their surgery. If you're already taking a narcotic pain medication like hydrocodone or oxycodone before surgery, it is important that you try to decrease the number of pills you are taking before you have surgery. Ideally, you should stop taking them completely for at least 4 weeks ahead of surgery. It is also important that you start gradually slowing down your use of the medications within the first few days after surgery. There are a number of ways you can do this. Apply cold therapy around the part of your body that has had the surgery. You will have a cooling unit while you're in the hospital that we will send home with you after surgery. Continue body movement, but decrease the amount or intensity of your activity. Use an appropriate assistive device. If you have pain walking without anything, use a cane when you're up and walking. If you have pain when you're using a cane, you should use crutches or a walker. After surgery, it's important to decrease how much you're focusing on your pain. If your mind is occupied with other things, you're less likely to be focused on it. TV, books, crossword puzzles, games, listening to your favorite music. Use anti-inflammatory medications if you can take them, or acetaminophen-based medications. Many patients have difficulty sleeping through the night for several weeks after surgery. Many medications will last between 3 to 4 hours, so sleeping through the night is difficult during the first few weeks after surgery. But don't be worried about this. It is something that will get better as you get further along after surgery. It's important that you do not use the opioid medication solely for the purpose of improving sleep. If pain at night is keeping you from sleeping, you might consider taking medications, especially anti-inflammatory medications, if you can take them, closer to bedtime, if you would normally be taking them earlier in the day. You may consider trying a topical anti-inflammatory medication to help decrease pain around the area where you will be having surgery. Be sure to ask your doctor if this is an option for you.